Okay, joining me to talk about these big developments, to discuss the relationship between Russia and India, Anil Gupta. He is the Michael Dingman Chair in the Strategy and Entrepreneurship Program at the University of Maryland. Good to see you again.
Good to see you again.
Welcome back. Look, this is a pretty big deal. A lot of people don't talk about Russia and India because there hasn't been that much in the past.
Yes.
Let me just start with that. How did we go from not much happening to all this that's happening right now, as we heard from Shweta?
Actually, a lot has been happening, but it's been very focused. So the Russia-India relationship really, in fact, 95% has been in the past. And past, I mean like last 50 years. It has been about defense and about geopolitics and almost nothing else. So for example, just take 2013, 68% of India's defense imports came from Russia. And India is the largest buyer of armaments in the world. So that tells you, you know, that on the defense side, the Russia-India relationship has been quite strong for a long time.
Yeah, I think a lot of people, unfortunately, we only get to the headlines, a lot of times we don't get further than that. But I want to get to some of them very quickly. We got $1 billion in infrastructure deals. We got 200,000 barrels of oil flowing between the two. That's part of the deal. We've got 10 nuclear reactors. We've got all these other little deals that probably aren't even making the headlines. Which one gets you perhaps most excited?
I think it's the energy side. That, of course, I mean, you know, see, India imports about $200 billion worth of oil each year, and less than $1 billion worth of that comes from Russia. So that $1 billion will, you know, become like $5 billion, $10 billion. It still will be relatively small in the $200 billion figure, but still it will be a nice development from India's side and from Russia's side.
What about the politics of all this? We can't ignore the fact that the U.S. is quite friendly with India.
Yes.
There's some issues with Russia right now, and you've got sort of India in between. What's happening with this little political game?
Yeah, I think what India is doing right now, and Modi in particular, I mean, he is a politician, but he is also like a shrewd businessman. And he thinks like the way Google thinks, you know, which is really make alliances with everybody, but for different purposes. So India has an excellent relationship with Russia, with China, with the US, with Japan, with the EU. And not all of actually these partners get along with each other. And so what Mr. Modi is doing, you know, Obama is visiting India on the 26th of January, in fact, as the chief guest on the Indian Republic Day. But at the same time, Mr. Modi is, you know, talking about dosti, which is friendship, with Mr. Putin. So he's really playing all sides.
Modi campaigned on reforms. Modi campaigned on turning the economy around. Modi campaigned on reforming the country so it would be better prepared for the next decade, so to speak.
Yes.
All these deals, whether it's China or Russia or later potentially with the U.S., is he doing it? Is he doing what he promised to do?
This is all about that. In fact, there are two things that Modi is passionate about, which is economic development and defense. And everything, anything and everything that he is doing with every one of these partners, it's about economic development and defense.
Okay, so we have the deals. How long is it going to take before we start seeing some concrete movement, at least with the economic numbers?
I think India-Russia?
In India. Oh, specifically
India.
For India.
Oh, I think, I mean, in India already, if you look at this year, GDP growth projections are about 5.4%. Next year already, OECD and others are talking about 6%, 6.5%, which actually, you know, would be quite a nice pickup. And then already for 2016, projections are above 7%. Ultimately, it's like, you know, the proof of the pudding is in the eating. And if we see GDP numbers go up to 6+ next year and 7+ the year after, I think that's pretty good.
I'm going to ask you to predict something. The biggest surprise that might come out of India next year.
The biggest surprise that come out of India next year would really be, I think GDP numbers that are higher than 6.5%, because, see, if India's GDP numbers are higher than 6.5, India might actually grow faster than China. And that might make India the fastest growing among the 10 largest economies in the world. And I think that'll catch a lot of media attention.
That will certainly catch a lot of attention. Anil Gupta, professor, thank you very much. University of Maryland, good to have you here for your analysis. Thank you. A new